same evening, you know, Arundel will miss that whole pathway, there is something hindering it there. And it's bad electrical wires, basically, and there's a hindrance of the flow of electricity. Failure of any part of the conduction system to deliver signals. You can have a not-so-bad one, first-degree block. Here you have a prolonged PR interval. Let's go back, I'm gonna go back now to our strip. So they're saying, if there's a heart block, there's gonna be a longer PR interval. Because you should have P wave, contraction of the atria, then ventricle contraction. But they're saying something's blocking the signal. So now the big upstroke is further away from the P wave. And so this little P to R interval, that little line, P to R, is longer because there's a delay. And so when they see that on the strip, it's like, oh, there's a heart block. Yes?
If that is, would you see the relaxation of the atria then? Would you see that blip then, before then?
Yeah, does it affect the, you know, like one thing trips?
Typically, you don't.
Else trip?
You may, but typically you don't, but you may. It's not always clear cut, but typically you don't. That's an excellent question. That's a great question. Okay, I'm going to go back now. So that's first degree. So the first thing for a mild heart block, did I go too far? Failure of any part of the condition. Okay, first degree, long, prolonged PR, usually asymptomatic. They see that and it's like, okay, it's a first degree heart block. So, you know, no symptoms. What's the big deal? Well, if you have a first degree, you know, maybe like in 3 months you may, advance to a second degree. So it's like, we need to watch this. Or they may need to treat it. They may need to treat it because you don't want it to go to second or third degree. Secondary degree heart block. The action potential is blocked at the AV node. And the atria will contract and the ventricles will not. You drop a beat. Sometimes it may be 2-1, where the atria beat 2 times and then you have a QRS. Or maybe 3-1 or 3-2. So you have this rhythm. 2-1, 2-1, all the way down the strip. Or 3-2, 3-2. But you're dropping. There's a second degree block, so you're dropping a beat, a QRS signal, so you're losing that. But it is rhythmic. It's not random. It's a 3-1 all the way down, or 2-1 all the way down. And then of course the worst one is third degree block. The impulse from the atria does not go through the AV node, and the ventricles beat on their own. The ventricles beat when they want to, and the atria beat when they want to. And so now we have this random. You may have 3 Ps, 2 QRSs, 1 P, 4 QRSs, and so it's just random. It's not 2-1, 2-1, 2-1, it's 2-3, 2-1, 2-2. And it's all over the place. That's a third degree heart block.
So can like a chamber ever become like engorged with blood?
All that's possible. Actually, this is dangerous. It must be treated. You see at the bottom of it. And if the total block comes and goes, it's called Stokes-Adams syndrome. What that means is you do an EKG, I see it. And then you do another EKG, oh, now it's normal. Right? And then it comes and goes. It's infrequent. But if it's consistent, that's your heart, it's beating like that all the time, that's dangerous. That needs to be treated. A nodal rhythm, we're still talking about abnormal, no P waves. because there's no SA node activity. So the P waves, that first wave is gone. It's not there. All you see is the QRS and the T waves. That's it. Heart blocks, some P waves do not go through the AV node and do not generate QRS complexes. You can have premature ventricular contractions. And that's the strip that we started off this lecture with, the upside down QRS. Occurs with no P wave. Inverted, misshapen, and no P wave. Premature ventricular contraction. You got, you're throwing in an extra ventricular beat in there. And then we have defib, which is just all over the place. Irregular waves of depolarization. One of the biggest signs for someone had a heart attack, or is having a heart attack, is the S2 segment. So think, what should you think here? Okay, so the S2 segment is that flat line between the QRS and the T wave, that flat line. If that's elevated, that means a myocardial infarction. That's a pretty important sign. So an elevated S2 segment, myocardial infarction. Q wave may be enlarged, may see ventricular fibrillation. Okay, so let's look at these strips. Here's normal. We have our P wave, QRS, we have our PR interval, flat line, we have our S2 segment, and we have our T wave. Here we have what's called nodal rhythm. Remember, normal is sinus rhythm. Nodal rhythm is when you have no SA node. And take a look, where's your SA node? There's no P wave. Nothing here. So you know that the SA node is not working in that person. You see that kind of a EKG scale. Here's a premature ventricular contraction where you have an upside down QRS and you don't even have a P wave. Where's your P wave? It should be here. No P wave, upside down QRS. You're throwing an extra ventricular beat in there. Heart block. Here we have three P waves and then a QRS. 3-1. Three P waves, one QRS. 3-1. If it stays that way, in consistently 3-1, 3-1, that's a second degree heart block. You can see the erratic nature of a ventricular fibrillation on the bottom, all over the place. Now we're going to be putting this all together. So one of the hard parts of the cardiac cycle is all the stuff that's going on at the same time and keeping track of it. Right? It's like, okay, SA node fires. What happens to the EKG? What's going on there? Oh, P wave. You got to put it all together. What's going on with the valves? Are they open or are they closed? It's putting it all together and understanding it that way. That's what you want to get to. A good way to do that is to make a chart of all the stuff going on. On the top, label EKG, and then down, all the stuff that happens during the cardiac cycle that's happening in the EKG. P wave, PR interval, QRS. Then you have a column that lists what's happening to the valves, open or closed, all the way down. So that you can look at that chart and go straight across and you can say, this all happens at the same time. When this happens, then this happens. That's what you want to organize it like. Auscultation is listening to sounds made by the body, the stethoscope. First heart sound is called S1, sound one, S1. It's louder and it's longer, and it is sound that the AV valves make when they close. So when you hear the first heart sound, the AV valves are closing. That means the tricuspid and the bicuspid mitral valve is closing. S2, second heart sound, softer, but sharper, occurs with the closure of the semilunar valves. So the heart sounds are the valves closing. There is a third sound, which we're really heard in people over 30, that you can actually hear the movement of the blood from the atria to the ventricles. It's called an S3 sound, third heart sound. And if you hear it, you call it a gallop. Three sounds, a gallop on the horse, also called triple rhythm. That doesn't mean pathology, that just means that you hear the heart, the blood actually moving.
Why do you only hear it on the engines?
Because if their heart is beating crisp, clean, and clear, and you're not old and decrepit.
Wait, you
call me? Yeah. That was all me. S4, rarely heard, is actually you can hear the atria contracting. So, heart sounds, S1, S2, know that they're the closing of the valves and which valves are being closed. S3 is the blood moving from the atria to the ventricles. And S4, which is where, is the contraction. Cardiac cycle is one complete contraction and relaxation of all four chambers of the heart. Systole is contraction, and so you have atrial systole, and ventricular systole. Diastole is relaxation. You have atrial diastole and ventricular diastole. There is a quiescent period when the heart is at rest. That means that no chamber is contracting. The right and left atrium are not contracting, and the ventricles are not contracting. Doesn't mean pressure's not going on and things aren't going on, but there's no muscular contraction. It's rest time in regards to muscle action. And that is the longest part of the cycle, which seems really strange, which means very good test question. Longest part of the cycle is when it's quiet. You wouldn't think that. If you were making a guess on the test, it's not what you probably would guess. You would think, oh, when the ventricles are contracting, you know, strong, powerful, have to contract long. No, the longest part of the cycle is when nothing is contracted. The most important driving force to move blood through the heart is the contraction and relaxation of the ventricles. The atria definitely are important and assist. Those ventricles are what's really pushing stuff and the driving force of the cardiac cycle. AV valves open. So phases, quiescent, all chambers relaxed. AV valves open and blood flowing into the ventricles. Talk about that. So this weekend, if you decide on making a chart, like I'm mentioning, your columns should should be. Your colleagues should be, first of all, what's going on? Right? So what's happening? Let me put what's happening. Talking about inferior, superior vein cava, blood is going into the right atrium. What's happening is what I'm talking about. The next column should be the conduction system. What's the SA node doing? Is that working? What's the AV node doing? Is that working? Where's it at in regards to the conduction system? EKG, you can tell a person's age when they say EKG. ECG. What's cool? When this is happening, where are we at the ECG? Are we at the P wave? Are we at the T wave? Where are we? What phase is it in? We'll talk about the phases. For instance, we already talked about one. Are we in the quiet phase? Or are we in a different phase? So that, you see what I'm saying? So when this is happening, you need to be studying, so is this, and so is this, and so is this. That's how you put it all together. And when you understand it like that, it's pretty comfortable if you don't understand the heart. Understand all this thing. You can make this list. You can do what heart sound is going on. Is that the first heart sound, the second heart sound, or no heart sound? Maybe that's no heart sound at that point, which is quite a deep case. And then you can go on and on. You can talk about valves, that the valves open and closed. You can put anything in there that you want to help you understand. Lots of stuff online. I printed out some stuff, hopefully, that will help you. There's more than that. You may find a picture or something or a diagram that you like better. There's a whole lot in there. But that's what you want to set it up as. So during the quiescent period, all the chambers are relaxed. AV valves are open and blood is flowing into the ventricles. Then we have atrial systole. The SA node fires, the atria depolarize, P wave appears on the electrocardiogram. The atria contract and force additional blood into the ventricles. The ventricles will then contain what is called end diastolic volume of 130 milliliters of blood. In a normal situation, that is the maximum amount of blood that's in the ventricles during the cardiac cycle. No more than that. That's a full ventricle, 130 mLs. So what happens is, we have our superior vena cava and our inferior vena cava for the right side. So remember, same thing is going on the left side. Everything is going simultaneously. So when you see a P wave, it's not the right atrium contracting, it's the right and left atrium contracting. When you see the QRS, it's not the right ventricles contracting, it's both of them contracting. They're both happening. So that means that the superior and inferior vena cava will go into the right atrium, right? We know that from lab. And we know on the left side, we have the pulmonary veins going into the left atrium. And we know that at this time period, it's the quiet time. Nothing's going on right now. There's no contraction going on. So as the right and left atrium fill with blood from the body and from the pulmonary veins, the pressure builds up. And the tricuspid opens and the bicuspid opens. Simply because blood came in and forced them open. Now we have blood going into the ventricles because they're open. Now, there's a little special thing here to help you understand me. It's why I stopped and did this. I have not mentioned contraction yet because it hasn't taken place yet. So this whole thing is the quiet time. That's the quiescent time period. Where are we on the ECG? We are flat before the P. We haven't even got to the P because the P is the atria contracting. We're before the P. Now, if you look at a continuous strip, technically you can say it's from the T to the P. TP. Right? T to P is the quiet time. Put that down. So, if a question, and this is not a question, let's just put it in the form of a question so you can understand this. If a question was, what opens the AV valves? And someone would say, oh, that's when the atria are contracting. No, it's not. It's when the blood fills up in the atria enough to force the doors open, valves open. So you get what's called ventricular filling from the blood. This is a phase. It's called ventricular filling.
Is the whole vein quiet or just the right
whole thing?
The whole thing is.
Yes, the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I should have put that over there. So the whole thing. So this is all quiet. From the right side and the left side is quiet. You get ventricular filling. Haven't contracted yet. And so this takes on a special term called passive filling. Not active, passive, no contraction. It's just a pipe open and it's just flowing in there. Nothing's forcing it in, it's just flowing. We're still at the quiet time. So that quiet time goes all the way down to there. We'll put passive. Because we also have a ventricular active filling. Because now it's time for the atria to contract. So you get this little bit of blood that flows in, passive, and then the atria says, oh, let's squeeze more. Now we contract. We're going to squeeze more. Now we have active filling. I'm running out of room down here. But now we have the active filling. And now we have, we're done with quiet. The quiet time's over. Now we have our P wave. That's where we are on the ECG, the electrocardiogram. The P wave.
So the passive filling is
so now we have this blood being forced into the ventricles. So what happens is, the total amount of blood that goes from, normally, it goes from the atria to the ventricles is 70 mLs. 70. You don't need to know what I'm going to say next. Know the 70. You don't need to know what I'm going to say next. If you look at percentages, passive filling gives you like 20 of the 70, and then when it contracts, the active filling gives you the 50. So 20 trickles in, and then it squeezes 50 more, 70 total. You don't have to know 20, 50. I just did that so you can understand. You have a passive and then an active. You just gotta know the 70. The 70 number, eventually 70 mLs gets into the ventricle. And at the end of this, the amount of blood in the ventricles is 130 on our slide right there. So if 130 end up, and you just put 70 in with your squeeze, that means it had 60 in that. So 60 is always sitting in the ventricle. Is our number. So it goes from 60 sitting in there to 130 after the atria fill it up. And the ventricle is going to eventually eject, is what it's called, ventricular ejection, into the aorta and 70. It's always passing 70 along and keeping it 60. It takes 70 from the atria, then it's going to shoot 70 out of it into the aorta and the pulmonary trunk. This is cardiac cycle. We're going to go partway through this. Right? This is how you want to wrap it all together to understand it. You want to put it all together so that you know that when I'm in a quiet phase, all chambers are relaxed. Doesn't mean that stuff isn't happening. We know it is. Blood's going into the atria, opening the valves, passively filling the ventricles. That's all quiet time. And then the active time comes in and squeezes more blood into the ventricles. So now we have all this blood being squeezed into the ventricles. The semilunar valves are closed. They've been closed the whole time. What's going to happen to the AV valves because of all that pressure in the ventricles? They're going to close. Because remember, we don't want the blood that just went to the ventricles to go back up into the atria. The pressure in the ventricles closes the AV valves, but it's not enough pressure to open the semilunar yet. All right. So the AV valves close, and what heart sound is that?
The first.
The AV valve's closing. There's your heartbeat. There's where you want to put that in the column. Right? When the AV valve's close, I have my first heart sound. So all that stuff took place, and then you heard the bulb of the first heart sound. Now remember, this is all 0.8 seconds. Always amazes me as we're trying to make sense of this to understand it, and someone came up with it.
You could open your body and figure out your heart.
Okay, I think that's enough. We can continue on to say.